Hello friends, this is Yogesh Murugan. In this video, we are going to talk about a priority algorithm. So the basic use of a priority algorithm is to get association rules. Now, where are these association rules used? So the best example is Amazon. When we go to Amazon for shopping and we purchase something, you might have seen the messages like the person who bought this item has also bought this item. Right? For example, the person who bought pen has also bought pencils, right? So these kind of messages are possible because of association rules. And from where we got those association rules, or how Amazon is able to show you this kind of recommendations or the messages, so it's because of association rules. From where we got those association rules, so you can get association rules by using an algorithm like a priority algorithm. So, if I want to tell you in simple words, it's like whenever we go to a shop and if we purchase something, that shopkeeper may also ask us to purchase some other thing which is related to the thing which we have purchased, right? Again, same example, if we purchase a pen from the shop, that shopkeeper might ask us to purchase a book, right? It depends. So, the same principle is also used here in case of Amazon also, but Amazon uses association rules, and it has got, and we get those association rules from where? From an algorithm like a priority algorithm. So what we will do is we will learn a priority algorithm by using this particular example. So just assume that these letters are the items and this is the letter we are having. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 records. So ultimately what we are going to do is we are going to derive some rules for this particular data by using a priority algorithm. How to do that? So that we will see. So let's start with the same. Now, as we are given, so what is given in this particular example? We are given these 5 records. Okay. We are given minimum support. So what is minimum support? Minimum support is given as 60%. How to use minimum support? That we will see as and when we will proceed with this example. Minimum confidence is equal to 80%. So this particular data is given to us, and minimum support and minimum confidence is given to us in this particular example, and we are going to find out the association rules by using a priority algorithm. So from this given data, first of all we will find out support. So how to find out the support? Support is equal to minimum support into total number of records. So minimum support is about 60%. So just add down 60% like this, 60 divided by 100 into 5. Why 5? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because 5 records are given in our original table. So that's a multiplied by 5. So what is support? Support is equal to 3. Right? 60 divided by 100 into 5 equal to 3. So this is how you can calculate the value for support from minimum support. So we are going to use this value. After this, next step is to make a table like this, item set and support count. Now what is this support count? This support count is nothing but the count number, the count of that particular item, or number of times that particular item has occurred in this table. So n has occurred 3 times. You can even check, count it, m 1 time, then m 2 times, and then m 3 times. Similarly, I have written the values for other items also. For example, who has occurred for 4 times, n 2 times. Like this, we have written the values for all the items, and at the end, C has occurred 2 times. So you just count how many times those items have occurred and write down the counts here. So you will get a table called as C1. You will just call it as C1. So item set, support count. This is what we got, right? Now, next step is what? As the value for support is given as 3, and we got this particular support count, what we have to do is we have to use this support to eliminate the values. How? We will only consider only those items which is having support count minimum 3. That means we will consider this, we will consider this, this will not be considered, this will be considered because it's 5. We want 3 or more than 3. That's right. So 4 will be considered, 3 will be considered. So 1, 1, 1 not considered, not considered. Right? So this is all we get next table. So we will call it as L1. So we got these items M O K E Y. So M O K E and Y. Why? Because the value of the support is 3. So we will only consider those items which is having support count as 3 or more than 3. That's why we have written only these values. So this is what we got. Okay. It's like, for example, in campus placements, for example, the industries, if they are asking for 60% criteria, right? So what they will do? They will eliminate the candidates by using a particular criteria. They will not consider the candidates who are having percentage less than 60, right? So exact as same. The values which are less than 3 for support count, we are not going to consider. We are only going to consider the values which are having the value as 3 or more than that. Only those items we are going to consider. So this is how we got this. Okay. After that, to give this particular set, what we will do is we will make a group or we will make a pair of items. So how to make the pair of items? So like this. M O. So that's why I have written M O. Right? M O. Then M K. So write down M K. Then M E and then M Y. So M E M Y. Okay. After that, O K. Then O K. And then O E O Y. O E O Y. And then K E K Y. K E K Y. And then E Y. So like this, make a pair of items. Okay. And then next thing is just count it. How many times M and M O together has occurred in the original table, that we need to count. So M O has occurred one time. Okay. And is there any other time M O has occurred? No. So M O has occurred only one time. Similarly, count M K. So if you count M K, so this is the first time M K has occurred. This is the second time M K has occurred. So 1, 2. Is there any other M K you are able to see? Yes, M K. So that's why M K has occurred 3 times. So that's why 3 is there. So like this, we have counted other pairs also. Like this, and at the end E Y. Okay. So say counting is done for the pairs. After this, what is support? Support is 3. So eliminate those pairs whose value is less than 3. That means these pairs will not be considered. The values, the pairs having the value less than 3, those pairs will not be considered. So this is how we got the final or the next table. MK3, OK3. So the values are 3 or more than that. Only those pairs we are writing here. After that, we make a pair of 3. So how to make that? MK, OK. So what is the common thing? K is the common. So what we can make from this? MKO. So write on MKO. Then MKOE. There is no common thing. MKKE. MKKE. So you can have MKE. So write on MKE. So and then MKKY. So you can write on MKY. MKY. After that OKOE. Then OKE. You can write on OKE. Then OKK. OKE is already written. So no need to repeat it. Then OK. KY, so OKY you can write on, instead is written. Then KEKY, KEY you can write on, that's also written. And after that, what is the next step? Just count how many times a group of 3 items has come. How many times MKO has come in original table? So MKO, one time. Is there MKO? Any other time? No. So that's why I have written 1. So like this, you go on counting group of 3 items from this original table. That means how many times 3 items are coming at the same time. So if I want MKE, it is 2 times it is coming. MKE one time and then MKE 2 times. So I have written 2. So just it is just a counting. So I have counted and written the values. After this, next step is again check support is 3. So eliminate the values which are less than 3. So there is only one value or one group which is having value 3 or more than that, that is OKE. So just write down that value. That's why OKE is equal to 3. And last step is you need to make a table like this, in which we write down association rules, then support, then confidence, and then confidence in percentage. So from OKE you can check what different types of rules you can make. So you can make O and K use E, O and K use E, then O and E use K, O and E use K, then K and E use O, K and E use O, and then just reverse that. E use OK, E use OK, K use OE, and O is O use K, O use K. So it is very simple. So that this is how we have written all the possibilities for the rules. So this is what comes under association rules, and then write down the support for each one of them. So we have already calculated the support. Support is 3 for each one of them. So I have written 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, and then calculate the confidence. Now what is confidence? The formula for confidence is this. Confidence is equal to support divided by number of times this left side has occurred. Okay, so confidence is equal to number of times it has occurred. So that is the formula for confidence. If I want to calculate the confidence for this particular association rule, how I will calculate? I will write down the support, that is 3, divided by number of times OK has occurred. So I will have to check how many times OK has occurred. So OK has occurred 3 times. That's why 3 divided by 3 equal to 1. That's why confidence is 1. OE use K, support is 3. So how to calculate the confidence? Support divided by number of times OE has occurred. So OE also has occurred 3 times. That's why 3 divided by 3 equal to 1. Now we will check for this one. KE use O. How to calculate the confidence? Support is 3 divided by 4. Why 4? Because KE, you check KE. So KE has occurred 4 times. That's why 4. So like this, you can calculate the confidence for other rules also. So we got these values: 1, 1, 0.75, 0.75, 0.6, 0.75. So 1 is nothing but 100%, 100%, 0.75, 75%, 75%, 60%, 75%. So for each rule, we have got confidence in percentage. Now, what is the value of the confidence? Minimum confidence given. Minimum confidence given is 80%. So we will have to apply an elimination criteria. So we will consider only those association rules whose confidence is minimum 80%. So this will not be considered, this will not be considered. That means only two rules will be considered. Which are those two rules? That means if a person purchases O item and K item, that particular person, you can suggest him or her to purchase E also. And if there is a purchase for O and E, so one should go for purchasing K also. So these are the two rules we got from a prior algorithm, by applying a prior algorithm to this particular example. So many times you can see it, you can see these rules, and many times it is called as analysis or market basket analysis. So many times you will see this kind of rules used for market basket analysis. So these are the two rules which we got by applying a prior algorithm to this particular example. So it's very simple to get the association rules from a prior algorithm. So there are a number of examples. One of the best examples we have discussed, that is Amazon, where we get suggestions, right? So in our case, we got only two rules. If there is O item someone is purchasing and there is K item someone is purchasing, and definitely he or she is going to purchase E item. Similarly, O item and E item, then someone, then definitely he or she is going to purchase K item. So it is nothing but market basket analysis. So this is all about a prior algorithm in short. So that's all. Thank you very much for watching.